Kind of, yeah.
Without him was not anything that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it.
I never really know what to get.
I never really know what to get everyone for Christmas. I went to the mall the other day and all I found was things that nobody needs.
I know. I don't know what I want for Christmas. Like, maybe a cool pair of socks? But who wants socks for Christmas? I want to know what is the ultimate gift.
Excuse me, people who have just wandered onto my stage, and forgive me for intruding, but I can't help but think I have a story that might be of some use. Are you familiar with the parable of the unforgiving servant? It's about the ultimate form of giving, that is, forgiving. One day, Peter, that is one of his disciples, asked Jesus a question. When a person does something wrong, how many times do I need to forgive? Should I forgive him 7 times? And Jesus answered, 77 times. Then Jesus told the story to tell what forgiveness is like in God's family. A king had a servant who owed him a lot of money. The king ordered his servant to pay back the money he owed, but the servant did not have any money. So the king was very angry and decided punishment was in order. The servant fell to her knees and begged the king to be patient about getting his money back. The king thought about this for some time, but eventually he said, I will forget about the money you owe me. You are forgiven. Go in peace. The servant was very happy and relieved. The next day, the servant saw a man who owed him a few coins. She grabbed the man and demanded he pay him back. The man fell to his knees and begged the servant to be patient about getting his money back. The servant thought about this for a little while. But eventually, the servant refused and had the man thrown into prison. The king heard about this and was angry and had the servant sent to the detention room. To prison, I'm sorry. Jesus teaches that God loves and forgives us more than we deserve and more than we can ever repay. God's love and forgiveness can help us keep forgiving each other. The thing is, this story is not just about a bad, unforgiving man. It's actually about all of us. We all have someone who has not forgiven us, despite how much God has forgiven us of all our sins. Anyone you've ever talked bad about or been angry with because you've had differing opinions, anyone who's ever hurt you, anyone you didn't like, you don't have to look far to realize that we have done the exact opposite of Christ's example and what he has done for us, just like the servant did to his king. So back to the question on what should I give for Christmas? Consider starting with what God gave us for Christmas, his son and the forgiveness of sins.
Thank you.
Cried out and said, "Whoever believes in me believes not in me, but in him who sent me. And whoever sees me sees him who sent me. I have come into the world as light, so that ever believe in me may not remain in darkness."
Stars are brightly shining, it is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and never pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Voices. Truly, he taught us to love one another. His law is love, and his gospel is peace. Chains he shall break, for the slave is our brother, and in his name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus raise, we let all within us praise his holy name. Christ is Lord. Oh, praise his name forever. His
proclaim.
Yeah.
You would choose me, just a lowly girl from a simple family. Who am I that angels speak my name, called to be the mother of the one who comes to save? Oh, what a king, Emmanuel, God with us. The world will call you Jesus, I will call you son. Oh, what a king, heaven will adore you.
Sorry.
Oh, what a king, born into a world of suffering. They don't know the gift I know you're gonna be. I wish I could protect you from the pain, but something's telling me that that's the reason why you came. Oh, what a king. Jesus, I will call you son. Oh, what a king, heaven rests before you, adores you, waited one. Oh, what a king. Holy, holy, lying in a manger. Jesus, I will call you son. Oh, what a king, heaven wills before you. Your mother, she adores you, long awaited one. Oh, what a king. Oh, what a king.
Thank you.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would someday walk on water?
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters?
Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new?
This child that you delivered will soon deliver you.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy gives sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will calm the storm with his hand?
Did you know that your baby boy will stop the angel's cry?
When you kiss your little baby, then you kiss the face of God.
Mm-hmm.
say, throw cares away. Christmas is here, bringing a cheer to young and old. Ding dong, ding dong, that is our song. The joyful ring, all caroling. One seems to hear words of his cheer from everywhere, filling the air. Oh, what they found, raising their sound, horn and the gales, rattling their tails, hearing the ring while people sing songs of good cheer. Christmas is here. Ding dong, ding dong, ding dong, ding dong, ding dong. From everywhere, filling the air. Oh, what they found, raising their sound. Oh, what they found, telling their tale. Giving their ring while people sing songs of good cheer. Christmas is here.
I am writing you no new commandment, but an old commandment that you had from the beginning. The old commandment is the word that you have heard. At the same time, it is a new commandment that I am writing to you, which is true in him and in you, because the darkness is passing away, and the true light is already shining. Whoever says he is in the light and hates his brother is still in the darkness. Whoever loves his brother abides in the light, and in him there is no cause for stumbling. But whoever hates his brother is in the darkness and walks in the darkness and does not know where he is going, because the darkness has blinded his eyes. I thought I'd come back and let you know what should have happened with the unforgiving servant. So let's get back up to the point where the servant had an opportunity to forgive the debt the man owed. So, if we recall, the next day, the servant saw a man who owed him a few coins, and the servant asked about the debt, and the man explained that he was broke. The servant considers this, what the king has done, the man, and realizes what he must do. Instead of insisting on being paid back, the servant forgives the debt and, out of generosity, decides to send the man on his way with a few extra coins as a gift. The king hears about this, but is pleased with the servant. What started with the king's mercy and generosity ends up with his people caring for one another and living happily with one another in peace and harmony.
Nations rise, join the triumph of the skies. to the world the Lord has come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing. Joy to the earth, the Savior reigns. Let men their songs employ, while fields and floods, rocks, hills, and plains repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy, repeat, repeat the sound. Singing joy for the lonely, joy when it's hard to come by, joy like a river that never runs dry, joy for the ages, joy in the morning sunrise, joy 'cause it's Christmas, he's with us, he's given us this joy.
Can I lead you in closing prayer? I think we pray with reverence. Let's pray. Our Father in heaven, we want to thank you at the close of this assembly for the wonderful hour so that we could spend together, for the opportunity to enjoy the talents of so many of our classmates, and we pray that each of these individuals and their talents could be used in service to you. And what a blessing to be able to listen, to be able to celebrate, to anticipate the birth of Jesus Christ, our Savior. What a gift. And we're thankful that in this free land, we may celebrate that gift as much and as often as we like. We're not restricted in our worship, in our singing, in our praise. And we're thankful that we may have that opportunity. We think of Christians around this world where it's really difficult to be a Christian. We pray that you would also give them an extra measure of your blessing and your comfort and your love. As we anticipate a break, as we anticipate opportunity to spend time with our family, as we anticipate Christmas, we pray that you would indeed bless our time of fellowship, our time of worship, and may the ultimate gift be the reality for each one of us. As we head home, we pray for travel mercies. We pray you'd keep each one of us safely in your care. Some of us need to travel quite a distance. Some of us just a lot fewer miles. We pray that you would care for all of us. And we pray all of this in Jesus' name alone. Amen.
Gentlemen, thank you very much for coming. If I could just ask the students to sit down for a second, I still want to dismiss you by grade. And a couple of instructions before we go. We still fully expect to have school tomorrow, which means that you need to make sure that you go back to your classes, put your stuff back in your lockers. However, in the event that there is no school tomorrow, you should probably make sure that you have everything you need out of your lockers before you go home tonight. So I expect to see you tomorrow, and be prepared for not being here. Grade 12, you are dismissed.